birds' poems under the rain. The moon was but the sheen of gold, and I took to a coat. And now she turns a perfect face upon the world below. Her forehead is of endless blonde, her cheek like barren stone, her eye unto the servant hue, the likest I have known. Her lips of amber never part, but what must be the smile upon a friend she could bestow with such a civil will? And what a privilege to be but the remotest star, for suddenly a way may pass beside your twinkling door. Upon it is the firmament, the universe a shoe, the stars the trinkets at her belt, a diminutive of blue. By Emily Dickinson. The next poem is Moonrise. At the end of the road through the woods, I see the great moonrise. The fields are flooded with shine, and my soul with sunrise. What that mystic orb with a shadowy beams should be the revealer at last of my darkest dreams. What if this tender fire in my heart's deep heart should be wiser than all the lore of the sages of old? By Bliss, Carman. The third and last poem is Moonbeams. Away, away from a five-winged bower, where ye love to come in the evening hour, to silver the leaf, to smile on the flower, and checker the scene so playfully. Away, away, for the mad yesic, half a darkened eye and a pale, pale cheek, as the lonely walk and the flowers all speak, while they hang their heads so mournfully. Away, for the voice ye used to win, with its soft, rich melody found within, is used, is gone as it never had been, poured out so sweet and fillingly, and the fearful harp that ye could make its deepest and tenderest notes awake. Now hath not a string but it fain would break. They lie so long and listlessly. Away to the slope of the dew bright hill, where the sod is fresh and the air is chill, where the marble is white and all is still. All asleep, beauty sleeping peacefully, but never within.